We're old, Bob. My grandson's favorite Joey story, which is my stories of my life, is when I got thrown out of the tunnel in Glacier. It's the longest tunnel in North America, I think.
Yeah.
Riding in the boxcar, you know.
Yeah.
Got thrown out there because I emphasized that I thought I was blind after the train left me in the ditch. I thought I was blind because it was so pitch black.
Yes.
So this show was going to be called The Pitch. But I don't really, we got 8 pages, and I was supposed to put songs to them, so I think it's just going to be called Pitch Black.
Okay.
Because I told a little bit of the story right there, didn't I?
You did.
Yeah. We are the muse that has the news, and that is why
we sing the blues.
We set the limo for you, because you got to take the ride out the country road there, to the cornfield of dreams where the old country artists and all different kinds of artists come out and request their songs. And then we end up at the station, finish the show up at the station.
So
it's pulling up just outside the door to your mind in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are the muse that has the news, and that's why we sing the blues. Well, I never felt more like singing the blues, Ma, did I? I never did.
Never did. You never did, Dad.
Never felt more like singing the blues. I never thought I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Well, never felt more like crying all night. Everything wrong, nothing is right without you. You got me singing the blues. Well, the moon and star no longer shine. Dream is gone, I thought was mine. Nothing that bore me to do but sigh over you,
over you.
Well, never felt more like singing the blues. I never thought I'd ever lose your love, dear. Why'd you do me this way? Oh, I said your love, dear. You got me singing a boo ba 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 boo ba 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 boo ba ba boo. Yeah.
It's not my fault.
Okay. Well, do you want to just sing us a little song? I won't be long. I got to go over here and see a man about a dog. No, are you okay?
I'm okay.
If you're like breaking up, I won't do it.
Huh? I'll do it. I'll do this old one, this old reliable.
Oh, and this gives me actually, that's a perfect lead in to what my first thing down here says. What does it say? Okay, time to give the people a real deal moment, Molly.
I wanna go all over the world. Start living free. I know that there's somebody who is waiting for me. I build a boat steady. Somewhere knows where you are. Stay, little star, steady and bright, to guide me afar. Rush, little wind, over
straight into the arms of my dear someone.
Very smooth.
Hey, it sounded pretty good, but I heard what I could hear.
Yeah.
Sounded pretty good.
Yeah. I'm feeling pretty good today. Pretty good.
I wanted to harmonize, so very harmonic sort of song. It cries out for it a bit. Here, I got something funny. Oh, we got to get moving, I guess. Yeah. But, you know, we are the muse that has the news.
That's why I'm
just getting, it's just a riot what's going on in, the U.S. of A.
Usually is.
And I got an idea. Put in the Donald, put him back in the presidency. Mm-hmm. He, just to see what they do.
Yeah.
Because you watch them. They're like really trying to get him.
Just as a social experiment.
Oh, totally. And I also thought, see what they will resort to. And then I started to imagine if you're making a movie, mm-hmm. Hunter Biden could be up in the telephone pole mm-hmm. outside the White House mm-hmm. with a sniper,
mm-hmm.
Sniper. It's getting that weird, man. It's getting that weird. But, yeah, that's right. That's enough.
That's good.
Yeah.
You want to take the ride, Dad? Let's take the ride.
I want to take the ride. Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Up as a honky tonk.
Past a honky tonk.
Past the county line.
Past the county line.
Through the amber waves of grain.
Through those waves of grain.
And past a dairy cow.
The big brown eye.
To the old cornfield dream.
Cornfield dream.
Only Molly can see these guys.
Cornfield of dream.
Who's coming out tonight, Mom?
Cornfield of dream. It's Dean Martin, Dad.
Dean Martin. Old country singer. The Dino.
Dean McMartin.
Some of our biggest fans are Italian. Maybe the biggest man.
Yeah, Mario?
No, Pasquale. Yeah, baby. Hey, hold on. Oh, is this what you want, like here, right here?
Yeah, sure. Say A.
You mean the song that I used to sing when I was working on the gondola?
Yeah, back when you were working on the gondola.
Down in Bannister?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When the moon.
Yeah. When the moon hits your eye like a baked pizza pie, that's amore.
Amore.
Bells will ring. Ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, you're gonna know you're in love.
So in love.
Gonna walk in a dream. No, you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
When the stars seem to shine like you had too much wine, that's amore.
Amore.
Oh, ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling,
you're gonna know you're in love.
So in love.
Gonna walk in your dream. No, you're not dreaming, it's in your way. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore. That's amore.
I think we should do a country song. What do you got? What was next? Song. What did you have up next?
I'm so lonesome, I could die.
Well, that's a good one for Hank to come out now.
Yeah, that's a. I got it in a C though, Dad. You mind moving it down there to see what that's okay. Like?
Wait, say it again. Say it again.
Hear that lonesome whippoorwill?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Okay. Okay. I don't know. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know if it's the right key.
I think I feel like harmonizing sometimes in it, so I don't know what's gonna happen. What is it again?
Hear that lonesome whippoorwill.
Hank Williams' Pain Songs and Jerry Jeff's Train Songs, yeah. Did you hear that lonesome whippoorwill? He sounds too blue, too fine. Oh, that midnight train is winding low. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
The silence of a falling star lights up a purple sky. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Oh, I've never seen no night so long. When time goes crawling by, the moon just went behind a cloud to hide its face and cry.
I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Good enough.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, now that you see a song like that transforms me out of it, makes it real hard for talking and crap.
Well, we could just get
it's
the
muse. It sends me into some muse.
We could just take the rest of the ride, and then it might be a good segue for you back into talking.
Yeah, means of contemplation. Yeah, that's right. It's kind of a bridge.
Yeah.
Too far.
Yeah. Wait. Move it down.
Okay. Where? There?
Wherever you are.
Yeah, old F sharp.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite.
Old reliable.
Yep. I like the F, and I like to be sharp.
Mm-hmm. F and sharp.
I like to be F and sharp. Wait, what are you doing? Oh, because all the girly is toe.
All the girly toe.
Hanging out of the window.
Hanging out of the window.
Somebody sees a great big old radio tower, 50,000 watts.
Station GHRT.
There for you and me.
There for you and me.
Brought to you by Alice's Restaurant.
You can get anything you
and
want.
And General Store.
Down at Alice's Restaurant.
restaurant. Ooh,
down at
Dallas is a restaurant.
Except Dallas. We're going to pull up the old station there, go in the front door, and go up to the front desk and see Betty Page in her cigarette girl uniform. She'll give you your special tea with the ayahuasca in it and send you down the stairs here to the Psychedelic Prairie Home Companion. Really big old-time radio medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin and her old dog, Jim.
And the very Reverend Dr. Joey G2 coming to you live from Station GHRD in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. And we don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back,
spin them on our soul.
Chill out, and relax.
Sometimes we spin them on our soul.
To the mellow
soul.
Sound.
Listen to this. This is funny too. Again, I'm not like being really political. I'm trying to get the comedy of the situation.
Yeah.
It's kind of horrible, but it's great. That's the way everybody evolves. They fight it out. They get into conflict. I thought we were completely out of the woods, but over there in Eurasia, apparently not. Anyways, listen to this announcement. I'm announcing somebody here.
Okay.
Big politician. Ladies and gentlemen, the embodiment and personification of American pride and grit, Mr. Donald P. Trump. 78 serious life sentence charges, and he keeps on ticking. Don't you think that's like, should somebody just say something like that? You know, I don't know what he stands for or anything, but Jesus, man, could that guy take it or what? I watched him sit there when Obama chewed him out at that press conference thing, and I thought, how can you do it, Donald?
Yeah.
It's like unbelievable, man. He liked, but you know what? He was brought up by that big preacher.
Yeah.
Norman Vincent Peale.
Yeah.
Positive thinking works. And I'm telling you, they can't knock him down.
Can't knock him down.
Well, you know, they'll have to get some bigger guns. Okay. What do you got? Enough of that crap. That's the last time I'll ever say anything about the news. Except we have the news, and that is why we sing the blues.
So on that note,
yeah,
because of Donald and how he can't be knocked down, apparently, we have Long May You Run.
Oh, yeah, that's perfect. That's perfect, isn't it? I'll just say one thing serious before we...
No.
Okay, then not.
No, you can if you want.
This might be... You could buy this into that. I just wanted to say this. This is serious for a minute. The parent, because there's a lot of parents out there in this situation, right? They're in a situation of so bad conflict.
Yeah.
One has to give up,
yep,
and appease the other,
mm-hmm,
right? The parent that appeases is the parent that rescues the children's mental health.
Mm-hmm.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
And therefore life.
Yeah.
They are the real evolutionists.
Mm-hmm. But what about the parent who, like, appeases in the way that they just let this other parent get away with all this bullshit?
It's the whole thing. And that's management, man.
Yeah, and then the kids are like, why didn't you do anything,
no,
other parent?
Yeah, that's not really a problem. You know what I mean? That's not going to be near as big of a problem as kids growing up with trauma.
Mm-hmm. But that's what I'm saying. It's like there's plenty of parents who one is giving everyone trauma and the other parent's not doing anything about it because they're just trying to.
You can't.
Yeah.
That's what you don't understand.
Yeah.
You can't. We have no health care system. Our health care system is a criminal enterprise.
Yeah.
And they don't recognize anything right.
Yeah.
You're screwed.
Yeah.
You're sitting there and there's millions of parents in this.
Mm-hmm.
And they just go, I got a cave.
Yeah.
It's my kids.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. It's bad.
Yeah.
That was too serious, Dad.
Okay, sorry. Okay. What was the other one leading into there?
Donald Trump.
Oh, yeah. Long may you run, Don.
Yeah.
he's the Don.
Goofy Don.
This is not a political show, and I'm not. Okay, wait. Oh, yeah.
We've been through.
This is actually an advertisement for Neil Young.
Yeah.
Good Canadian boy.
He's a big Donald Trump fan.
Oh, I bet he is, yeah. I can imagine it. He don't even like Joe Rogan. He likes Dr. Fauci.
I was gonna start
doing the Lonesome River. Where is it again?
We've been through
some things together. The trunks of the memories still come. We found things to do in the stormy weather. Long may you run.
Long may you run.
Down in Blind River in 1962, last I saw you alive. Running down that empty ocean road, into the surf on time in Saskatchewan. Long may you run, yeah. Long may you run. And though these changes have come, may you grow on shining in the sun. Long may you run.
Long may you run.
Long may you run. You run. Yeah. That's for everybody. And I'll do the pitch now. Here's the pitch.
Okay.
It's supposed to take a whole show.
Yeah.
Well, I discovered the impetus of human brain function was to evolve.
Yep.
And it told us a whole bunch of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And got developed into a therapy.
Mm-hmm.
And there's really no reason for much of the depression and anxiety, because it's like a fantastic reframe therapy.
Yeah.
But what I found out was there's a whole $4 trillion industry
mm-hmm.
fighting to keep this kind of thing away.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you can, there's doctors down on Twitter, they're yelling, I sent you a thing.
Yeah.
Going, this is crooked. This is no good. You can cure it all with diet and exercise. Don't be an idiot. Don't feed into it, right? Because they got to keep you sick to make money. So they normalize things like fat and anxiety and shit like that. I mean, it's a criminal enterprise.
It sure is.
Why is that talking about that? Oh, yeah. So a lot of money, a lot of money to publish up against that. You got the whole thing against you, mm-hmm. right? And I'm talking about a lot of money. And that's my pitch. I need it. Maybe you could just cut that little segment out, Mom.
Yeah.
Might work. Because I don't think they want more than, like, 2 minutes or something. Oh, the hell with it.
Yeah.
I can't. That's the only way I can talk about money.
That's good. Yeah. You want to sing another song now?
You see, the thing is, I never got money out of anybody unless they were getting way, you know, back.
Yeah.
Back, right? So that's easy, selling that shit. Okay, what was the, you say?
Glory Days.
Oh.
Wait.
This is a real oldies show, Ma. You got no...
I don't want any newies.
Not, but Travis Tritt, Smoking Bar, stuff like that?
Yeah.
What is this again?
Glory Days.
Notice how I do this with one hand.
Great. Amazing.
I
had a friend who was a big baseball
player. Oh, yeah, that's right. I didn't... Yeah, I did. But he couldn't throw a speedball button.
No.
No. You know what my average was in last year in Little League?
What?
850. 850. That's a true story.
Last year in Little League.
Just like the train in the tunnel.
Yeah.
These are true things, man. Going to be a book coming out. You're going to want to read it. I figure I have to sell a billion books, make a dollar a book. I can jump in with Elon Musk and those guys.
Yeah.
Joe Rogan. What is it again? Oh.
Glory days.
I got to start thinking. I had a friend, he was a big baseball player. Well, back in high school, he could throw that speedball by hand, make you look like a fool boy. Saw him the other night at this roadside bar, walking in, he was walking out. We went back inside, we had a few drinks, old man, and all he kept talking about was glory day. Pass you by, glory day. Wink of a young girl's eye, glory day. Glory day.
Pass you by, glory days, in the wink of a young girl's eye, glory days, glory days.
There's a girl, she lives up the block. Oh, back in school, she could turn all the boys' heads. Sometimes I stop by on a Friday, have a few drinks before she puts her kids to bed. Here's her husband, Bobby. They split up, oh, I guess it's 3 years gone by now. We just sit around talking about the old times. She says when she feels like crying, she starts laughing about it. Glory days. Pass you by, glory days. Wink of the young girl's eye, glory days. Glory days.
Pass you by, glory days, in the wink of a young girl's eye, glory days, glory days.
I'm going down the well tonight.
Yep.
I'm gonna drink until I get my fill. I hope when I get real old I don't sit around talking about it, but you know I probably will. Just kicking back, trying to recapture a little of that Gloria. You know when time slips away, leaves you with nothing, mister, but the coolest stories of glory days. Pass you by, glory days. Wink of a young girl's eye, glory days. Glory days.
Pass you by, glory days, in the wink of a young girl's eye, glory days, glory days.
Pass you by, glory days, wink of a young girl's eye, glory days, glory days, glory days. Do anything healthy?
Yeah.
Well, there was laughing and singing. That's all healthy, right? We are the muse, it is the news. We did some funny stuff about the Donald.
Yes.
We could do Biden next time.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His ex-son-in-law calls them the Biden crime family. LOL. It's the best show in town. No. Our show is the best show in town because it's the heaviest podcast on the planet. Because it's about the deep health, baby. You're trying to evolve, and if you cooperate, health and happiness will be yours. Because we're trying to evolve to a higher climb. You can decide on the climbs you want. Now listen, hold it. Because when you got your health, you got just about everything. So you pee-picking hillbillies, you come on, come back now.